Welcome to Facebook for the Blind, your look at the downfall of Western civilization through the best memes we can find each week.
Glad you were fucking born, etc. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, both and neither, is that time of the week we like to celebrate Facebook for the Blind, a show for the visually and Facebook impaired. I am your often humble host, Eric Sizemore, joined by my beautiful co-host, Quiet Michael Labune.
Yeah, it's me. Let's go.
Nah, do it again. You weren't pinned.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Please continue.
You got to spotlight it, not pin it.
Oh, not pin it?
Spot pin it.
Pin is for you. Spotlight is for everybody. Watch. See, you go.
Pin it sounds like
spotlight.
Penis.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then there we go. And brain damage. I love it. Oh, no.
How am I here by myself now?
Oh, there Oh, we're all over the place. I'm loving it. They are going to have, and we are going to have some funny, funny memes for you. But first, a trademark, patented, copyrighted part of every single episode of Facebook for the Blind. You know it. You love it. You know what I'm talking about? Does anybody know what I'm talking about? I think some of you know what I'm talking about, but I'm not sure if everyone knows what I'm talking about. But we are indeed talking about the depressing news. So long. Well, you know, maybe if we did it, I could adjust.
Sure.
No,
we should definitely do it again. That's fucking great. Also, we're number one in depressing news.
We are number one. And those other guys have been ripping us off. I am thinking about filing a complaint. Facebook for the Blind, depressing news for April 30th, 2024, brought to you by McDonald's. McDonald's, you can get real food for what we charge now. Da, 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 da. It's true. That's right. Also, brought to you by us, I guess us, by Facebook for the Blind, episode 156, the happy birthday episode. I didn't have time to update the slide from last time, so it's going to say, you know, April 23rd, 155. But you guys can imagine what it would be like if it was, you know, new. Here's a fun chart about just all the military aid that went to Israel. You can see it's like a lot, and it's very different than the way it's been before. That's fun. So yeah, billions in aid for Ukraine, Israel, and whatnot. Brought to you by Anarchist Ties. Anarchist Ties, steal this tie.
Use this tie to light a Molotov cocktail if you want.
All right, depressing news. Hey, the world's most successful political party is facing extinction. Britain's Conservative Party faces a fight for its very survival. Oh, well, that's not depressing at all.
That's fucking great news.
No, I'm sorry. I try hard, but it's every once in a while one will slip in, and I apologize for that. So
no good news. This is depressing news time.
Hey, come on. There's a lot of stuff going on today. Large numbers of New York City police officers have begun entering the Columbia University campus. So probably some heads going to get cracked, some physical violence going to be done. A lot of zip ties, I'm betting.
Maybe they're there to learn, Eric. Do you ever think
police?
About that?
The police?
Yeah.
Maybe. Sure. Hope springs eternal. Just as we were going to press, Trump is held in contempt for violating his gag order in the hush money trial because the boy can't hush. And here's how much he owes. I don't care. He's not going to pay it. Doesn't matter. Biden administration, as we are going to press, is planning to reclassify marijuana, easing restrictions nationwide. That's right. So you don't have to wait for your stupid cracker state to figure things out. Now the feds will take care of it and hopefully smooth things over. So going to be putting marijuana in the same category as Tylenol with codeine and steroids, both of which are part of a balanced breakfast. Russia has officially added the LGBTQ movement to its list of terrorist and extremist organizations. At least according to coverage by UFO sightings, hashtag UFO sightings. So, you know, take that for what it's worth. Kristi Noem. Did you hear about the governor, Kristi Noem? Well, Kristi Noem had a shot at being the Trump VP before that whole dog killing boast. Did you hear about the governor killing dogs? Anybody?
This is like Reagan. Fucking political. Like, I just don't understand why in the world someone would crush their own future this way. Like, you know, what a fucking idiot.
You know, I think part of it is like when you're just a faux tough guy, it's hard to figure out what a faux tough guy would do, you know? But I love it, man. South Dakota governor trying to justify her killing of her 14-month-old dog. And the headline is, "Stop making excuses, Kristi. That dog won't hunt." Pretty good. She defended herself by saying, you know, well, shooting cricket was totally legal. I'm like, oh, my God. Legalism, last refuge of scoundrels, in my humble opinion. How about some good news? Construction is starting on a high-speed rail between Southern California and Las Vegas. How crazy will that be? The Brightline train is going to connect Las Vegas with Rancho Cucamonga in just 2 hours. And for those of you who don't know, decades ago, the city of Cucamonga said, "Everyone makes fun of the name of our town. How could we improve it?" And they said, "I know, Rancho Cucamonga." I love these people.
I tell you what they're saying is that it'll take 2 hours to get from Rancho Cucamonga to Las Vegas, and it takes forever to get from Las Vegas back home.
Now, I'm pretty sure this is a train
fucking
that goes
way longer ride back.
Oh, well, that's true, actually, yeah. Yeah, the ride out there has a bar car, and the ride back has a sobering up and getting over your hangover car, extra oxygen and Tylenol. I see that. I can see that. Totally.
And payday loans. They fucking
payday loans. No, just sign right here. Just sign right here. It's fine. Hi, Bob with Bob's Portable Pawn Shop. That's a nice ring you got there. All right, I just love a good headline here, and this one was great. The Daily Beast Obsessed just ran with, "Shocker, Johnny Depp's comeback movie doesn't totally suck." This one was funny for me. The Tesla Cybertruck breaks down after going through a car wash. Did you guys hear about this? Remember, it's got bulletproof windows. And remember, you know, that the Cybertruck can be temporarily used as a boat. Bulletproof truck does not appear to be waterproof. Users are joking, and I had quite a few things. One thing that kind of blew me away is that I don't remember which site this was, but they looked in the Cybertruck's owner manual, and it indicates that you should caution not to wash it in direct sunlight. It's bulletproof, but in direct sunlight, if you whip out a sponge, you can just bring it to a halt. yeah, and it says damage caused by car washes is not covered by the warranty. I'm so sorry. But, oh my God, suckers. As we talked about at the top of the hour by accident, supplemental bill has become law, and billions of dollars in aid are going to Ukraine very fast. They're also going to Israel, which has caused a few hiccups back here in the States, you might say. Friend of the show, Jem Narikas, reports that four of NPR's eightest largest sponsors are insurance companies. So how fun is that? Insurance. NPR wants you to be insured. Not sure why. More Perfect Union has reported that McDonald's workers in Denmark make over $20 an hour, and Happy Meal is $6.20. So maybe we have a greedy boss problem here, not a minimum wage is too high problem. Because a headline from April 2nd says, "I can't charge $20 for a Happy Meal." McDonald's franchisee responds to California's new fast food worker wages. "I can't do it." Because you're greedy, bastard. Right. Brought to you by McDonald's. Yes, McDonald's. You can get real food for what we charge now. Dum-da-da-dum-dum. It's true. Granny Farty Pants. Oh, I know there was some farting in the news. I feel like very strongly there was farting in the news. This was a placeholder graphic for farting. What was farting? There was a lot of...
They say Trump was farting in court.
Oh, I remember now. It was Mars. Did you know that NASA is pondering why gas produced on Earth, which is farts, is leaking out of Mars, but only at night? Mysterious puffs of farty gases all over Mars. And yeah, people just making jokes about it, being very rude. This was probably my news post with the most. As you can see here, I've got 210 comments and about 29 people liking it. It is just colleges with Palestine encampments from the City University of New York in New York City all the way through Indiana University at Purdue, which is pretty crazy. And I said, hey, it reminds me of the Divest Now Shantytown protests on the UIUC quad back in the 80s. You remember there was apartheid, and then college kids started building shantytowns on the quads, and then there wasn't apartheid, so it was like really effective. Anyway, growing by the minutes, and if you know what you're talking about, you're like, oh, hey, well, what's going on at the U of I? Well, I would tune into the alma mater cam, but the pigs shut it down. They actually shut down all the live cameras. So lucky for you, I got a student who went there. So here's what the UIUC Liberation Zone looks like in front of, that is, I know the name of that hall. I'm drawing a blank on it. It's the birthday cake building.
I never had a class there.
Follinger.
Yes, Follinger.
Follinger Hall. So camped out Follinger Hall. They have a kitchen tent. They have a medical tent. They have a whole bunch of other tents on the quad there. And this sort of a broader picture there. But I'd say there's quite a few folks there. A lot of folks with tripods. A lot of media coverage there. So screw you shutting down the alma mater cam. There's your U of I campus. Hey, did you know that have more Palestinians or Israelis died in the war in Gaza? Half of Americans don't know, the poll says.
What the fuck?
Yeah. So I posted and asked people, which half are you in? And I got to tell you what, a lot of them have no freaking clue. So just in case you're ever pulled into this game, the official government statistics, you know, those ones that are always notoriously low, but are documented and official, 26-1. Current score of the Palestinian-Israeli ongoing conflict, 26-1. So that's horrible. That's what that is. It's absolutely horrible. We always have a heartwarming animal story, and I'm sorry I have to go with a fake one, but the right went into a tizzy because they got sucked in with AI art that said Build-A-Bear was having Baphomet parties. That's right. That's right. It's just satire. Baphomet birthday parties. They've got Build-A-Baphomet. You can build a Baphomet at the Build-A-Baphomet workshop. And enterprising Americans went out there and started making actual Baphomet Build-A-Bears. So you can buy them now. I'm sure you can just Google them. I'd show you pictures, but who cares? Anyway, Build-A-Bear had to actually come out and say, no. Like, no, we're not doing anything like that. Little reality check there. Just satanic Build-A-Bears, but fooling people on TikTok. Also, speaking of furry things that don't exist, freaking out adults, bogus furry panic overtakes Utah school district. They actually staged a whole protest. Group chats viewed by the Daily Beast showed they brought I don't know, a few dozen people. They had students walk out of class and chant.
So are they wearing a mask?
Like to say, you know, we don't want furries in our schools, as though there were, but there aren't. A school district had to go out of its way to explain, we don't have furries in our school. Anyway, well, people lost their freaking minds, which I just thought was absolutely ridiculous. And finally, this one made us think of a friend of the show, Clay Foley, a wild but true story of 171 cats and dogs that were airlifted from a war zone. This guy survived suicide bombs, AK-47s, and special forces actually helped him load crates of puppies and cats onto a private airplane, partially paid for by Ricky Gervais. Link in the doodly-doo on the thing. 100-degree temperatures, they're in crates at the airport. Some fire engine showed up and they sprayed down the crates and probably saved their lives. I mean, this story is absolutely bonkers how great it is. And here's a picture of a couple cats in a laundry basket. You know, this is the true story. I'll put a link to it. It was wonderful and absolutely great. And that has wrapped up Facebook for the Blind's news edition for April 30th, 2024, my birthday news. Mwah! Now I hand it off to my beautiful host. quiet Michael Laboon for a nice medium-sized round one. Round one.
Wrong, Eric. Here comes a big, long round one.
Oh.
And happy birthday.
Thank you.
Starting off with this picture of three men wearing very short shorts and really super deep neckline shirts tucked into their short shorts. They all look pretty handsome. And it says, "This is the level of hoochie daddy I'm trying to be on this summer." So consider yourselves warned. Shithead Steve, friend of the show, Shithead Steve.
Hey, Steve.
He says, "College sophomore, quote, eat the rich, end quote." And then it says the house they grew up in, and it's just a fucking mansion.
Mm.
Man, this this was really true of my college experience. The Chive. Do you guys remember The Chive? Mm-hmm. Well, we do. Friend of the show, The Chive. They're out here, they're like fresh set, and they have an emoji of fingernails being painted with some stars. And then there's a picture of five French fries with the tips of them dipped in ketchup. This is a really fucking haunting picture for some reason. For our listeners, this just looks really, really fucking really weird. Oh, I love this. Moist Buddha, friend of the show, Moist Buddha, keeping it moist. Also collaborated with Shithead Steve on this one. Shithead here with back to backs. They're retweeting Discussion Film. So Discussion Film has these pictures from Inside Out Part 2, the one that's coming out. And it says, and they're reporting, the emotions shame and guilt were originally new emotions Riley got in Inside Out 2. Here's a quote from the rap. "It was not fun to watch. It was too heavy." Well, friend of the show, JP Brammer, he retweets this and says, "Release the Catholic cut."
Nice.
Courtney says, "Did a crab write this?" They say, "It is illegal to help baby sea turtles escape predators if you don't have a permit. If you see this, you have to leave it alone and respect the natural order of things." And there's a picture of a crab attacking a baby turtle.
That's awesome.
Okay, Devin. At Coca-Cola says, "Baconator meal cost $15. This the shit they were talking about in Revelations. I got three more for round one here. This is a picture of a button, and it just says, "Unclench my jaw in this economy." The Chive is back, and they say, "This meeting could have been a fist fight." And my last meme for round one comes to you from Trash Can Paul, friend of the show, Trash Can Paul. Love you, Trash Can. Here we have a picture of Paulie from The Sopranos, and he looks pissed off, and he's pointing with his pointer finger and his pinky like he always does, and he's pointing to a picture of beef stroganoff, and he says, "You're telling me this beef was stroking off?" And that's all I got for round one. Kicking it over to you, Brain Damage.
Awesome. All right. I'm doing this wrong. All right. Let me hit the right button. Now let's get this thing started. Okay. Let's not hit the right button. Now let's hit the wrong button. Here we go.
For our listeners, he did not hit the right button.
Yeah. He did not. Here we have... Old school bangers with a picture of a motel called the Packet Inn. And when we scroll out
pack
here,
it up.
We have, "Pack it up, pack it in, let me begin. I came to win battle you, it's a sin." We have Janine, I don't know how to pronounce this lady's name.
That's
Janine.
You're right.
Janine Rogers posted, "She's a maniac." And we have a poster board where there's a couple and the wife is spraying the cat with a spray bottle, and the husband says, "I think the cat's starting to enjoy the spray bottle too much." And we see the cat is dancing. Like, she's a maniac, maniac. What was that movie called? Oh, Tony
Flash
was
Dance.
Jealous.
Flash Dance.
Yeah. Thank you, Michael. All right. Now we got dumb jokes and stupid something. And we have a picture of a box plug and a circle, like extension cord plug. And the son has a hat on backwards, and he's one of those big, big, like, vacuum plugs with the third prong. And dad box plug says, "Sparky, your mother and I are shocked at your current behavior.
Hey.
Until you learn to conduct yourself properly, you're grounded." A little bit of electrical humor. All right. Fuck me then. Dad jokes to tell whatever. Says, "My wife says she's upset with me because I never buy her flowers. To be fair, I didn't even know she sold flowers."
That's dumb.
Jamie Lair says, "Hashtag blush," and shouts out to my wife again because her hands look like this, so mine can look like this. And it shows her hands with nice red painted nails, but all dirty with all kinds of tar and dirt. And then it shows a pair of hands all nice and manicured with a PlayStation 5 controller. Yes. Yes, I love my PlayStation. Hashtag bless. I thought I took this out, but somehow it made the cut. It says Far Side fans, and it has some hens chilling in the hen hut, and one is coming in. And she says, "You guys just heard something really scary about who's guarding the hen house." And the other two chilling says, "Sheesh, Alice, have you been watching Fox News again?"
It was so bad.
The fox and the hen. Larry Smooth posted thebunny.com, and the bunny's thinking about a sock, and this is what I call a... What do you call those in comedy? The flashbacks?
Oh, yeah.
The socks. He's going through the tunnel. He escapes out the tunnel, and he's in sock heaven with the sock leader with the eye patch helping him out of the lake. Mm-hmm. That's my old school sock set. Now we know where socks goes. Bacon Salt posted, "I did it. I made an LGBT. And here we have lettuce, guacamole, bacon, and tomato. And I'm just wondering, Eric.
Yeah.
Where is the cucumber for the Q?" Fruit Bomb Comics. Okay, I see. Four panel. We have a therapist talking to Tomato. The Tomato says, "That's my story, Doc. And it feels good opening it up to someone." I see, the Doc says. Then he looks at his notes and says, "Day 7, speaking with an apple. Looks like I need therapy myself." And I said it was a tomato and it was an apple, so fuck me. And here's my last one for this one. We have Godzilla and King Kong. And King Kong catches one of the helicopters swirling around them. And he said, "Sometimes we just feel like taking a relaxing stroll through the park, okay? Stop profile." And that one's bizarro, my boy. That's it for me. Handing it off to you, Eric.
Another action-packed round one. Thank you all so much for making this show possible. Going to kick off my wholesome round one here on Facebook for the blind with an ad for Skatoon Network. That's right, the Skatoon Network, where you can catch Skatrek.
Yeah.
Skatrek. Skatrek on the Skatoon Network. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And Librarian Trivia. Are you smarter than a librarian? Trivia night. I will decimate you. Librarian Trivia night. Ask your librarian.
Depends on the categories.
About trivia night. This one was from George, and it's just truly crazy. It's in the wholesome round, but Wordfather says, "Shout out to the guy who created a parody account of the Cinema Sins, where instead of pointing out every single flaw in a film, he just points out things he likes about the movie." You're so right. Cinema Wins is so much more fun to like things. And... last one out says, "Cinema Wins once said every movie, with very little exception, is someone's favorite. I like to find out why." And that sentence alone is worth more than every single thing that Cinema Sins guys have ever created. How wholesome is that? Friend of the show and founding Zaddy, George Hussein Crutcher,
no,
has posted Ellie Bangs, and Ellie underscore Bangs says, deeply haunted by a study that found that human beings are less than 50% accurate in determining whether they are being flirted with.
That means we're not good at flirting.
I just know that this one had a lot of traffic, man. A lot of people identifying with this one. Here we got a shot from friend of the show and, godfather of the show, Jason Brown, who's talking about we don't want crappy AI. So we have a shot from Futurama, and we have, what's the central character's name? I can't remember his name. But, you know, the main guy, he's labeled as Ask Meta AI Anything. And it says, that's the Meta AI. You can ask it anything. And Professor Farnsworth said, ask it to fuck off. Here, Ashley Regina has posted at Classic Film Day. My friend just posted this with the caption, pickleball. And I cannot stop laughing because we have a ball. Like a ballroom dress and tuxedos, but they're all the people are pickles. Pickleball. new associate of the friend who posted old friend of the show. Intersexual memes and feminist dreams. And if you're not following intersectional memes and feminist dreams, I don't know where you're getting your feminist dreams and your intersectional memes. They have posted this delightful thing from Zach W. Lambert at Zach W. Lambert, who says, what's your funniest purity culture story? Mine's when my parents secretly installed Covenant Eyes on our computer. 1 week later, they confronted me about my porn addiction. I swore I wasn't, so they showed me my explicit searches. It had one entry, bare naked ladies. That's right. It's been 1 week since you looked at porn. here's a fun one. Lincoln Square in downtown Urbana opened, and this is just like the posting. September 16th, 1964, and the gentleman who posted it, Dan Hughes reposted it, he replied, it opened September 17th, 1964, and I said, right, how do you know the exact date? And he says, because I was born September 16th, 1964, and Mom never forgave me for keeping her from going to the grand opening. Wholesome annoyance. I want to go to the new mall. When's the last time somebody said that? And last but not least, the U.S. Federal Department of Propaganda. And if you're not following the U.S. Federal Department of Propaganda, where are you getting your federal propaganda? Has a post from Kyle at Plant Kyle emoji who says, y'all people are too sensitive these days. 60 years ago, man, she sat in what part of the bus? Yes. That wraps up my wholesome round for Facebook for the Blind. Back to you, Michael.
Cruising right along, round to the irrelevant round.
Oh, and if you haven't done drugs or gotten drunk yet, now would be a good time.
Okay. This one's coming from Shay Dozer, and it's got a picture of a wrestling match with a cage match, and it says, my body is not a temple. It's the 1998 Hell in a Cell match between Mankind and The Undertaker.
Hey, I can't see anything.
Why not?
You're not sharing.
Yeah, we can't see your screen, Michael.
It says that my connection is unstable. All right, just give me a second. It's got to catch up. We're doing it this way. Now can you see my body, which is a 1998 Hell in a Cell match between Mankind and The Undertaker?
Yeah.
Yes.
Moving on. Rachel Held Evans, friend of the show, friend of mine, who passed away a number of years ago. We miss you dearly every day. She, this is a memory from a tweet she wrote. This says, the early church would be utterly baffled by the idea that future Christians would shame someone for not swearing allegiance to the empire. Just your routine reminder that nationalism is idolatry. Trash Can Paul. Friend of the show, Trash Can Paul, is back. He says, imagine Netflix opened a physical store where you could go and watch movies on like a really big screen. And then they have they're dreaming of what this such a building would look like, and it's just a movie theater that says Netflix. The Hard Times, friend of the show, thehardtimes.net. Listen, if you're not following the Hard Times, where the hell are you getting your hard times? You know, they have a picture of Kristi Noem, and they're reporting Kristi Noem saves face by claiming dog she shot was infected with woke mind virus. So it's not as bad as you guys made it seem. Snow ho ho at hit cock bottom. Sorry, I've never read that handle before. Snow ho ho at hit cock bottom says, one time a guy picked me up to take me on our first date, and he was playing this god awful metal music, so I turned it down. And he legit made an illegal U-turn and took my ass right back home without saying one word. Oh. I would fucking hang out with that dude.
Wow.
Jenna Wortham. A friend of the show, Jenna Wortham. She says, someone told me L.A. is shitty heaven and New York is fun hell. And it makes me chuckle every time I think about it. And that's really fucking good.
It is good.
Like... L.A. is shitty heaven. Shitty That's exactly, heaven. Yeah, it's fucking, yeah. I got about three more for this round. Marina says, if you're feeling bad, it's because I paid a white woman on Etsy to curse you. Shithead Steve is back. Having a huge night, Shithead. Just a huge night for Shithead. He says, me, I think I'll go to sleep now. My upstairs neighbors, and there's just four panels of just absolute fucking like chaos. Mad Max chaos explosions. Yeah, we've all had that neighbor. And yeah, this is my last meme for this round. At WMBA girlfriend, at WMBA girlfriend, got it.
Nice.
Says, I need surgery. It doesn't matter what kind.
Oh my God. Wow.
I don't even know. You know, fuck it. I'm doing one more.
Do it.
The Hard Times, friend of the show, thehardtimes.net. Seriously, fucking follow him. I have a picture of Mark Wahlberg, and it says, Mark Wahlberg researches upcoming cop role by committing multiple hate crimes in the 80s. And that's all I got for round two, the irrelevant round, kicking it back to you, brain damage.
This time, I'm going to hit the right fucking button. Hopefully.
This time, he's going to fuck the right button.
Oh.
Hey,
he did it. He did it. This one, I think, was posted about some shit called horror movies. And it has Scoob in the gang, and they have Jason Voorhees tied up. And I think that's Velma, right? That says, all right, gang, let's see who this monster really is. And they all say, oh, jinkies, golly, jeepers, zoinks. And we see that. It's really Jason Voorhees, and then Fred says, that's new. And then here we have old Valeria from a Game of Thrones heads, and has a drawn version of Scooby-Doo, but as what looks to be possibly, I forget their names. God damn it.
Game of Thrones.
Yeah. But what was the Sam, oh, Sam, and the guy
night,
that he got
the Night's
killed.
Watch.
Yeah, at the Night's Watch, right? And they took off the White Walker's head, and they old man Craster. So yeah, all right. Let's see. Then we have a three panel. We have Mario walking with a smoke in his mouth. He's looking mad as fuck, and I hear guys, and he looks over. Oh no, and it's the turtle that he steps on. Says it's him, and there's the Ninja Turtles waiting in the shadows, and they're looking mad as fuck. And then we have a continuation, and here we have Nintendo Wonder posted. There he is, let's get him. And it has two pipes that are unconnected, and you see there's a bike posted on a wall, and somebody's drawn in some cool ass Ninja Turtles. Trying to get Mario, who has a blue turtle shell, which if you play Mario Kart knows that will kill the person in front. But that is a cool ass drawing, so I wanted to highlight that. And I messed it up again. I did it. I messed it up again. All right, here we go. Here we go. All right, here we have a two panel. It has a hammer man, and he comes home, and he has a board with a bikini on. He says, "Hi, honey. What the hell is that?" And if you look, her board has nails, 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 and then there's a screw.
Oh!
He's a screw. And then he goes to Screwdriver Man, and he kicks his ass. And that's from PBSComics.com.
Love it.
And then we have funny grandma jokes posted on a hippopotamus. There's a whole bunch of birds on his ass, and there's two birds riding on his shoulders. And he says, "This is the life. I'm never traveling the economy again." And all them birds are just back there with no view, riding the rhinoceros' ass. Did I say hippo? Fucking no. Jerk. The Comic Realm posted Gambit. It has Rogue. She says, "Okay, who touched my butt?" And Wolverine says, "Not me." Cyclops says, "Not me." And Gambit's all fucking drained.
I gotta ask, is everybody watching X-Men 97? Is it just me?
I haven't gotten to it yet. I fucking want to get to it, though.
I'm waiting for it to end so I can binge it. I don't want to have to wait a week between episodes.
I love it. Right. It's making this joke funnier. That's what I'm saying.
Nice.
But I remember Gambit and Rogue in the cartoon from back in actual 1996. That means
here we have, it says Tyler and Gates or something like that. Mm. All right, anyways, it has Moses parting the sea. Wrong place, wrong time, and it has a whale going, "What? What the? You gotta be kidding me." And he's stuck in the middle, but it can get worse, because here we have Moses parting the sea, says, "Oops," and he split that whale in half. So it's, which way do you want it, Mr. Mayor? Which way do you want it, Mr. Whale? And this is the last one for me. And here we have a four panel. We have some kind of hawk. He says, "Skull! I'm a motherfucking bird of prey, feared by all. Nature's perfect killing machine." And it says, "With my telescopic vision, I can track down any," and then it has the rabbit with a sign that says, "Come get me, you little bitch." I can't read it. I don't know. Sorry, person.
Zach, extra fabulous.
Extra fabulous. I love you, Michael. Thank you. Nice to you, Eric. Happy birthday, mother. Oh, love you.
Fucker.
Yeah. Good times. Heading into round two, the irrelevant, irreverent, irrepressible round. Right here, we got a picture of Dolly Parton in a fur, in a bedazzled dress. She's getting out of a limo. There's cameras flashbulbing all around, and it says, "Me welcoming whatever fresh hell this week has to offer." My friend Candace says, "You look fabulous." And I know. Other 98% would like to remind us that Wall Street wants you to forget that in the 1970s, the average American was able to work 40 hours a week and own a home, have two cars, and support a family on that single income. Oh, that's not funny. Ha ha. That's like funny. Ah, that's kind of strange. It's almost like there was a conspiracy to steal our slack. Moving on. Hey, here's a picture of Jimmy Carter and Rosalind Carter in the background, and Jimmy Carter is working some carpentry there at Habitat for Humanity. It's captioned, "This is what it looks like when a real Christian actually does something to make America great again."
Yeah.
Not so much funny, it's just a contrast with the world as it stands right now. Moving on, Pagan Memes has posted this. Y'all know Jesus sees your tweets, right?
Uh-huh.
Which you can get on a t-shirt and give me all your money at JesusSeeYourTweets.com. Send me all your money. Oh, no, there's the rest of this Pagan Memes 2 panel. Erica Flo says, "How you see my tweets, but he missed 400 years of slavery." Erica underscore flows at flow underscore with me. I'm with you. Friend of the show, Steven at Calzone. Wow, check it out. He got at Calzone. He says, Elon.
He got at Calzone.
Tazlone. Oh, smart. Very smart. It's good branding right there. Elon paid for an episode of Modern Simpsons to make Lisa say that he's smart. And in my eyes, that's the most pathetic thing a person has ever done. Steven replying says, Elon pays scientists to make toys for him and then tells Redditors that he invented the toys. And they believe him. Why do they believe him? Because he paid Star Trek to name drop him. Because he paid Lisa Simpson to say he's Batman. Divorce guy behavior. Musk was born divorced. I just love that title. I think we're going to call him Born Divorced from now on. Meanwhile, in the news, Born Divorced says his Cybertruck can float like a boat. This next one is just a picture of the girl from Mean Girls saying, Elon, stop trying to make X happen. It's not going to happen.
I gotta watch that movie. I've never seen it.
Oh, you already got the best line. What else do you need? But it's really funny. Paul was just like saying, correction, it's already known as Twitter. And I'm like, oh, it's so funny. Especially considering that he makes this big deal out of like dropping people's dead names. And it's just like, yeah, I wish I could see him to his face. Elon, love Twitter. Love using Twitter. Twitter's great. Dumbass. Hey, speaking of douchebags, Dave Cooper posts this one from the independent.co.uk. Russell Brand announces that he plans to be baptized after sexual assault allegations. So pay attention, guys. See if that works. You've been credibly accused of sexual assault.
I'm for this.
I'm for it too, but I mean, you know, my comment is I'm going to have a shaman say some magic words over me. Where's my parade?
Yeah, no, listen, if he wants to follow the way, that includes accountability, yo.
I mean,
get baptized, start owning up to your shit. Next comes confession. Let's do the whole thing.
I love it. You got a whole step by step here. This next one was posted by the First Kansas Anti-Fascist Brigade, and it's a comedian, and I don't know him, and I need you, TD, and I wish you were here. He says, three panel says, if you punch a Nazi, what's next? Well, hopefully more Nazis. Why would you just punch one? That doesn't seem right.
Yeah. Great point.
Yeah, it doesn't seem right. You know, like, well, who was with him? Got about 3-4 more here. Danesco Patriota at Danesco Patriota says, I've been dreading this post for a while now, but I finally must admit that I've lost a substantial portion of my life savings investing in the Donald J. Trump stock. I was unable to continue this slide and sold the majority of my stake this afternoon at $26.50 per share. This is a disastrous fall, resulting in a loss of nearly $500,000 of my retirement savings. I am now forced to return to the workforce at age 76. Please, family, learn from my mistake, and please do not put everything into one stock. It's like anti-QAnon memes has passed this along, and it's like, is that the lesson you got? Don't put everything into one stock. Follow me for more sharp investing terms. Oh my God. Anyway, so sorry, not depressing. Really funny. Really, really funny. A lot of stupid people are losing a lot of money right now, so that's kind of funny. This is a three panel of the interview of Oprah and Prince What's-His-Tush and his American bride, Princess What's-Her-Tush. And the prince is saying, so appropriately, you have to write the journal article. What? He says, apparently you have to write the journal article for free and other people have to review it for free. And then the people who own the journal charge thousands of dollars for anyone to be able to read it. And Oprah's going, oh. Posted in Reviewer 2 must be stopped. And if you're not following Reviewer 2, must be stopped. You are missing out on some killer academic memes. Got about two left here. This one, Steve Cottrell at Socialist Steve 6 says, my wife and I left graduate school 23 years ago with a combined total of $70,000 in debt. Since then, we've made $500 monthly payments for 23 years, $120,000 plus. Today, we still owe $60,000. Explain to me again why student loan debt shouldn't be canceled. From Tales of the Kitchen Witch. And I would just like to point out that this led to a tremendous conversation. You can see here, I got 35 reactions, 30 comments, 2 shares, a lot of back and forth, and a lot of people saying things. Well, at what interest rate? At what what were the terms of the contract? Dell, this is a post of a meme on Tales of a Kitchen Witch. There's no link to the fine print of the student loan contract, but I did find a compound interest calculator and discovered that these numbers are exactly right. They're exactly right. And I was just like, you're in the mortgage industry. You should be able to calculate mortgage interest. You should be able to calculate payments. Why did you think this was so out of line? And why did you make me do your homework for you? And it's because people believe what they want to believe, and no amount of math will improve that. So there you go. And lastly, Damon Adams, at that Damon guy, says, imagine if people knocked on your door to talk about science instead of religion. Hi, we just like a quick chat about the possibility of life in the atmosphere of Venus and thought you might be interested in hearing about phosphine. To my favorite is Mary Nia says, sign me up. How cool would that be? I would love that. Have you ever heard of Kirlian photography?
All right, kicking off round 3, the penultimate round.
Oh my God,
this one I'm kicking off with once again the Chive. We had a nice reunion this week, me and the Chive. Welcome back to my life, the Chive. It's a 2 panel. The first panel, we have a picture of Crocs with on the. Can you guys see it?
Not yet.
It's very. I don't know why, but I have to do it. I have to share twice now. Let's try again. Tell me when you see the Crocs.
I see me. Ah, Crocs. Got it.
I see you.
All right. So these are a pair of Crocs, but they have a little bit of swag on the back. There's truck nuts. They're but made for Crocs.
Oh, wow.
And then the second panel is the kid from Terminator, and he says, we're not going to make it, are we? I mean.
No. Signs point to no.
Next up, I have H. Wynn Art, who says Mario is from New York City. Plumber, Italian. Sonic is from California. Snarky, too cool for you. Crash Bandicoot is from Florida. High on bath salts, screaming.
That's awful.
I can't remember the name of this movie. That Brad Pitt was in, but it was the one with like the mythology. Oh, I think he played like Achilles.
His Achilles, oh. Yeah. What the
fuck yeah.
Was it called?
Yeah. I don't know. The promo for this movie had him jumping weird and stabbing that guy in the shoulder, the neck or whatever. Anyway, it says, quote, we sit on the couch. We don't jump on it like a trampoline, end quote. And then this picture is captioned toddlers. That's why no one will remember your name. Brad Pitt's putting on his helmet for war. Oh my God. Eric, will you do me a favor and read this one?
Absolutely. In Reddit, R Too Afraid to Ask, you character odd 6496 says, I had anal and now my butt feels weird. What's wrong? And the reply is, it didn't hurt and it doesn't hurt now, but my butt feels different and I don't like it. I can't explain it. This just isn't the regular hole I know and love. You know, the regular hole I know and love was the name of my high school band.
Eric, I am so disappointed in you. I cannot believe. The hardtimes.net, friend of the show, thehardtimes.net. It says quiz. There's a picture of a woman wearing a flannel and a gardening hat, and it says quiz. Is she a horse girl, or does she just do ketamine at festivals? Sorry, Asia at Asia DNYC says, why is it always New York smells like pee and never my pee smells like the greatest city in the world? this meme made me laugh harder than anything I saw this week, I swear to God. Hannah Joe at Whoa Hannah Joe Yeah, Hannah Jo at Whoa Hannah Jo. She's retweeting herself. So the first tweet says, "There's no way waterboarding is that bad. Might try it on myself and see what's up." And then she retweets that with and she just says, "Don't." I guess you have to have been waterboarding to get that one. Show me the yams. Says, ghosting a man feels so good when you don't have a therapist in your ear calling it an, quote, avoidant attachment style, end quote. And my last meme for round three, the penultimate round, leaving only my post with the most, shithead Steve. Fucking huge night, shithead. He's retweeting Stunky, who says, must be a nightmare to sing happy birthday to her. And then you see that he has a picture of a Chinese chemist named To You You. I give you all a second to just sing that in your head. that's right. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear, to you. Happy birthday to you, Eric. And that's all I have for round three, the penultimate round. Back to you, brain damage.
Ultimate pen. Let's do it. All right, here we have, I'm pretty sure this is Scott Metzger, and we have a man in a suit with a wand and a woman wearing a maid's outfit, and he's singing, they're riding your back, you gotta get whacked, bibbidi-bobbidi, and she says, no, it's okay, and it says, when Cinderella meets her fairy godfather. We'll see if this round has a theme. I don't know. Here we have the bunny. Bunny.com. He's painted a picture of the sunset. He sees a mermaid jumping out of the water. Oh, it's jumping in the water. And he's painting. Turns out it's not a mermaid. It was a fish eating a somebody. But he was digging it. He's got a nice little smiley face. All right. Here's a four panel from War and Peace. And we have Death riding a skateboard. He stops and he tells some kids, bet you can't do a kickflip over the shark tank. And the kid says, betcha I can. And Death says, I love my job. Here we've got... this is a friend of mine, Aaron Brown, somewhat of a mentor for me, posting Gen X, and Dan Duval posted, so sad that kids today spend so much time online. When we were kids, we were always outside, throwing rocks at one another, smoking, lighting small fires, stealing car hood ornaments, shoplifting, trying drugs. One time I drank gasoline. Facts.
Oh my
Thank
God!
God we didn't have
the... I miss setting small fires.
Thank God we didn't have cameras everywhere. Here we have Vines posted, redacted, posted. So my girl almost died three times in my apocalypse dream because she don't listen. I'm so irritated. And redacted posted the male version of you cheated in my dream.
Dude, I've had that dream.
I have too. I've seriously had that dream. Just like, we have to fucking, you won't listen. Like,
I kept fucking telling you to grab the shotgun.
Why are you going outside? Like, yeah, dude, swear to God.
My favorite was back in the like sort of, I don't know, I had this thing of like Nazis at the border, like sort of Soviet looking guys, and I had just pulled off the most amazing bullshit, and then my girl goes, no, we're not.
Lollygagging and monologuing. All right. Now, why do I have to move two of these things out? See, this is some bullshit. Zena's Doggy Tales posted, there's a couple of rats, and it says, there, it's almost like he's still with us, and there's a dead rat on the rat trap, and they just drew his face, they put him against the wall, and drew his face on the back of the mousetrap.
So lifelike.
Oh, gosh.
Too fun. Right.
And then here we have gaming layer posted. And it says, you don't have a skeleton inside of you. You are a brain. You are inside of a skeleton. You're potted in bone mech that's using meat armor. And it's the meme that has the lady with the awkward smile. And then she gets a close up and she goes, what? Meat mech. And this is the last one for me for the ultimate pen round. Never been deader posted four panner. And it's a skeleton man. And he says, I am by no means a selfish person. I'm always giving zero fucks. And I'm passing it off to you, Eric.
Nice. Penultimate round, kicking it off with the National Park Service. National Park Service would like to remind you that living your life to the fullest does not involve selfies with bison. Statistically, a whole bunch of people are not listening to this advice right now. And I love it. National Park Service kicks it off with, think of the paperwork. Tales of a Kitchen Witch, making a second appearance in the show with Glumshoe, says, imagine Bob Ross painting in the style of Hieronymus Bosch. This little demon here is kind of lonely. Let's give him some happy little friends. Little demon party. And Kisk says, Hieronymus Bob. And please don't squeeze the Charmin says, or please don't squeeze the shh. Says, it's your tortured human soul. You can choose how many blackbirds you want to fly out of his anus. Just as many as you think he needs. Just as many as you think he needs. Just make a little happy tree over here. Moving on, Moneyless Society has the two panel of the woman looking revolted and looking, and the revolted one is saying, being a terrible person. And then the is being a terrible person in the eyes of evangelical Christians. Victims of psychedelic class warfare and MK Ultra shitposting memorial fund. If you're not following victims of psychedelic class warfare and MK Ultra shitposting memorial fund, where are you getting your I can't do it, I'm out of breath. has posted this from Bo at Bo_Austin_. Said the protests are robbing my Columbia students of listening to John Cage's 4 minutes and 33 seconds, the piece of music that is explicitly designed to force you to listen to what's around you. But Professor John McWhirter complains that when he did it, he could just hear the chanting of the Palestinian Gaza protesters outside the classroom. So had to cancel class. Couldn't assign him to listen to that. not funny, just for me. This next picture is from the Omniscient Observer. Got a picture of a library, and it says, having a college reading level in third grade did not take me as far as they made it seem it would. Yeah, that's I'm in this meme and I don't like it. This next one is Dave Lovingood says, so a porn star, a Bible salesman, and a man named Pecker walked into a courtroom. And friend of the show Craig says, I guess I'm not up to speed here, what do you mean? So I posted, you know, I said Pecker, you know, I had my little Pecker, the little pecker that I made for this guy. Anyway, he goes, okay, I'm all cut up now. Friend of the show, Mike Murphy. Murph! Miss you, buddy. Good to see you. He's reposted Jeremy Flood at _floodlight saying, a good law of history is that if you ever find yourself opposing a student movement while siding with the ruling class, you are wrong. Every single time, in every era, no matter the issue. Yeah, it was really, really funny. Lot of different stuff. People, this was posted in the heart of the TARDIS, and a lot of people talking about the protests in a lot of ignorant ways. For example, my friend Dell said, and where is the protest against Hamas? And I posted a picture of a bombed out crater in Gaza, and I said, by the way, the rhythm of that phrase, where is the protest against Hamas, rhymes with, but when is White History Month?
Yeah.
FYI, Dell. Not saying you're saying it, but you're humming the right tune. John Fuglesang, at John Fuglesang, says, congrats to Governor Kristi Noem on guaranteeing the most disgusting thing in her bio is not sex with Corey Lewandowski. Way to go, Kristi. Friends of the show, Workers' Party of Massachusetts. Ah, thanks for all the cards and letters, guys, and keep on organizing. Nah. Workers Unite. They have posted JJ, a JJ is a Marxist, who says, I just want working class people to hate capitalism as much as it hates them. That's tight.
That's all.
That is a tight, tight slogan. And you can get that on a capitalist t-shirt from my store at hatecapitalism.com. Maybe. Friend of the show and founding Zaddy, George Hussein Cruxshank.
No, still no.
Has presented a four panel of cartoons from, I don't remember this, Extra Fabulous Comics. And there's a kid behind a desk in school, and he says, ugh, why don't you teach us about things we'll actually need to know as adults? And the teacher says, okay, I'm going to teach you how to do your taxes while also dealing with the death of a loved one. Please itemize your deductions while I deal with Mr. Hamps, the class pet. And she has a knife on the class hamster. All the children are writing and crying and frowning while there's a noise from off panel just going, squee! Extra Fabulous Comics. When your comics aren't fabulous enough. Friend of the show, Chuck, has posted this picture of a bedraggled, ragged, hollow-faced former disgraced president, and it's captioned, when you work the first 32-hour work week of your life at 78 years old. Imagine how great he'll look after five more weeks. That was posted, and it's time to make turtle soup. This next one's from friend of the show, James Fell. If you are not following Canadian historian and foul-mouthed individual James Fell, you are missing out. James Fell at Body for Wife has posted, hey guys, women know that bears can be dangerous. They still prefer the bear. Take all the time you need with that information. I don't know if you guys have heard this, but there was a preference for, like, would you rather be in the woods with a bear or a man? And the majority of women said bear. Adam Guidry has replied, wow, you're really milking this one. And he says, I'm sorry if that makes your penis fall off. Which, by the way, is a great response to all manner of things spotted on the internet and in real life. So I'm sorry if that makes your penis fall off. Friend of the show, Steve Rendell, has posted this headline for a tweet from Elon Musk that says, NPR has become a hard left propaganda machine that tolerates no dissent. And Tina's first comment is, I wish. How amazing would that be, ladies and gentlemen? Next up, we're going to have an entire panel of people explaining how to prepare and cook the rich. It'd be great. On Splendid Table. Friend of the show, Corey Showtime Robinson, says Elon Musk is like if Lex Luthor was a complete fucking moron.
Seriously. That's exactly right.
Brendan Weber has posted this picture of the Cybertruck, and it says, word for the week, wank panzer. Here we have a picture of Elon with a red sled, and the hardtimes.net has revealed that a new biography reveals X was the name of Elon Musk's beloved childhood sled. Do we need to say Rosebud at this point? No, we probably don't. Okay, three more and we're out. Friend of the show, Loreen, I believe. Yeah, Loreen passed this one along from Soul Nate at M. Nate Shyamalan. Says, jury duty is a wild concept. Whenever the government wants, they can just be like, hey, call off work, bestie. We need you to solve a murder. Here's $15. and reminder, Business Insider had reported that Elon Musk says you can soon use your Cybertruck as a boat as long as you don't car wash it first. And the troll from whatever says, looks like submarine memes are back on the menu, boys. The car wash brought it up again, guys. It's just too funny. And finally, a three panel from Daniel Cook. Two heads, and it says, "Don't look, but James is here." And the other guy says, "Did he bring the?" "Yes, he brought the fucking peach." And it's an enormous peach. Giant. Giant, even. James brought the... All right, screw it. I don't care. That's up my penultimate round for April 30th, 2024, leaving only our post with the most.
Here we go, Eric, kicking off the post with the most. Let's see. Tell me when you see the meme.
I see the meme.
All right. My post with the most for this week comes from Trash Can Paul.
Paul.
Love you, Trash Can. Love Here you. We have two of the good boy dogs. One of them is American. One of them's British. The American dog says, "I have a bloody nose." And he's got a little tissue in his nose. And the British British dog says, "Mate, we all have noses in it."
Or a bloody nose. So dumb.
What was your post with the most brain damage?
Mosting and posting. I was gonna actually finally follow the rules, but I actually would have been cheating because it would have been just for me, and it was a meme about the 49ers and the NFL draft, so I decided not to do it. And so here we're posting. This was from All Fun and Jokes Comics, and it said the artist is Dogs on the Fourth. So here we have a three panel. We have a man. He drops a French fry. He says, "Oh no, my fry!" And then we see two germs, and they say, "5, 4, 3, 2." And then he picks it up. He says, "Got it!" And they go, "Fuck!"
The germs. Oh my god.
Eric. Happy fucking birthday.
Thank you. I've never seen the mechanics of the 5-second rule worked out. That's fantastic.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Now it all makes so much more sense.
Right.
Joe Daniel Abrams on LinkedIn posts, "In a world where you can be anything, be the person who ends the meeting early." This email could have been a meeting. You're welcome. That I believe fully constitutes a legal rendition of an episode of Facebook for the Blind for April 30th, 2024. It's my birthday, and I love you all so much. Thank you for sharing this time with me. We love you. Mwah!
Happy birthday, Eric. Love you, George.
Happy birthday.
Woo-hoo! Happy birthday, Eric.
Thanks for listening to an episode of Facebook for the Blind.
Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.